السلام عليكم. Well, I'm gonna conduct this presentation in English, and I'd like to start by saying I am so proud. I am damn proud with these guys, Basil, Muhammad, the team. I am truly honored. I am truly inspired. This is a good job. This is a difficult job. This is not easily done. And truly, you are a great example of what I'm trying to illustrate today and what I'm trying to convey today. This is true impact. And the impact that you will create, inshallah, out of this, and positioning yourselves as role models, could spread so quick. I was just watching Muhammad Hafiz tweeting all about you just now, and I was so happy, and he is as proud as I am, and we're talking about a leader in the private sector. Can you help me? Today I'm going to talk about how a career of an individual, whether female or male, can transact and transform a society, and how you can do that. You as an individual, how can you look at your career as a journey, and a journey that spreads learning and collaborative impact across societies and communities. And in a very brief, inshallah, presentation with no technical details. So that journey, and consider it and look at it as a journey, you will graduate soon, inshallah. Some of you might end up as artists. This individual who just played on stage is a talented individual, part of the creative industry, and might someday choose that as a career. Whether you graduate today and you chose a career as an entrepreneur, as an artist, go into your education, higher education, none of that is better than the other. At the end of the day, look at it as a career. Please, next. Your career journey should be the only journey in life that you should not plan for it to end. It's an evolving journey with continuous learning and continuous development. I will try and summarize and be very brief, and I tried to put it all under an overarching three themes. The three themes are, I want to talk about how you can develop a career DNA. So your DNA in your profession, and it's mainly linked to you being a human being. And what are the checklist of what I call what matters checklist in that journey? And then how you can build what I call spheres of learning and collaborative communities based on your knowledge, based on your profession, based on your experience and expertise that you have developed over time. Next, please. So, the making of your career DNA, five steps. Step number one, believe in. What do you believe in? You believe in your cause. You should identify a cause. You should identify what is your inner calling. What is it that is calling you from your inside? You must have a purpose in life and go home and define that. I think today people who are sitting here are going to be future leaders. I believe that strongly. Today is Thursday night and you guys are here. That's amazing. And what you believe in could be anything, and as long as you feel powerful about it, you will be able to relate it and you will be able to link it to something that's good for the community somehow, as long as you're not a villain. Okay, next. Another trait that you should have in you is that humbleness. humbleness and continuous strive and continuous eagerness and hunger for learning. So you know nothing, and if you know that in you, of course you know a lot. Everybody, alhamdulillah, is learning and you're educated. There is a lot that you know that I don't know. But I believe that I know nothing and you know everything. Not everything, sorry. But you know a lot that you can teach me. So everybody here in this room has something to teach the other. And if you have that attitude, that you, there is so much more to know, you know less than many people around you, you will develop a network of learning knowledge. And that's what I'm what we will talk about later on in the journey. Next, please. Also do your homework, and I'm not talking about your school homework. Do your school homework, of course. Whatever Ustaz Mahmoud gives you, you have to do it. But here in the context of career, doing your homework is being prudent. Do things with excellence. Do things with a holistic view of life. What is your systematic thinking? When you do something, how does it reflect to other, to others? In your business, your supply chain, what does it look like? Your value chain, what does it look like? Who are your suppliers and how are they gonna get impacted with your decisions? Who are your stakeholders and who are you, how is the community going to be impacted with your decisions? Be holistic, do your homework and trust others. And being someone who is prudent with good homework in life allows him to be trustworthy and allows him to be a trusting person of others. Why? I was taught by a nobleman who I dearly respect, and I will say that in Arabic, and he taught me two important values: حسن الظن وإتقان العمل. حسن الظن does not mean that you would be a stupid individual who everybody can just wave anything across you and you will believe it and you will trust in him. No, that's because you excelled and did your work and homework with excellence. So there is no way something will pass by you or pass through you and you will be a dumb person out of your decisions. But have حسن الظن, faith and trust. Next, please. And that brings us to the second, the following trait, which is number four, trust. And this is built on my previous, on number three, trust in everybody who listens, trust in everybody who is noble, trust in everybody who has a good cause. Have some trust in others and have people trust you, and you can become trustworthy with your traits, with your virtues. Which brings us to the following point. Always be thankful. So I first say thank you, Basil and Muhammad. These guys, I was privileged and honored to coach them in my previous career when I was in Jeddah, and I was a volunteer with a program in Injaz. And they are truly, truly talented individuals. And I thank you for giving me this honor today. And I continue to say thank you to anybody, and you have to be thankful to anybody who did something, showed you something, shared with you something, shared knowledge, anything that you feel that you owe a thank to, don't hesitate. Be thankful. And don't hesitate to ask. So as much as you are thankful, as much as you have the right to ask, keep asking, as long as you don't know it. Keep asking. Next, please. So these are the things that are gonna build your DNA as a career professional in whatever career you wanna pursue. And these things are traits that will just have you work as a magnet with others. It's not gonna give you skills, it's not gonna give you a talent, it's not gonna give you anything except you being empathetic, as someone who can magnet people to you, who can network with others, who can explore life, who can explore knowledge, and it, then it allows you to start your career journey. So what really matters in this career journey? Who you meet? Who heard of Virgin? Richard Branson, owner, CEO, owner, chairman, I don't know what he is right now, of Virgin. But Virgin is a global brand, and quite an impressive book this guy wrote, and it's all about who he met. Now, what I'm trying to say here is take advantage of who you meet. Today, I think not everybody knows everybody in the room. I hope not, because then we would be planning this as a group and we just come to the expo. So I hope we're meeting new people today. I met new people today, and I would love to continue building these relationships with them. And those people, actually, I'm gonna save my this point to my next following slides. But it's who you meet that's important, because everybody you meet could have something very valuable, or a common benefit, or a common interest that you might have, and then that relationship would lead to something very fruitful. So, also read, or view YouTube, or do all the channels that, you know, gets you info or delivers information to you. However, when you do that, you must always link it to something that you would benefit from for your cause. So we had a cause and we defined our purpose. So it's sometimes we all, every day in our daily life, when we read, we're The Economist, we wanna read fashion, we wanna read about art, but sometimes it's out of only curiosity and reading for the sake of reading. However, make sure that you can trigger things in your reading and highlight it, and link it to your cause. These things, over time, if you document them and if you collate them and consolidate them, you won't believe what a project can this create for you over time. So what you have read 2 years ago and it's highlighted because it's linked to a cause that you have in mind, today, after 100 documents that you have highlighted, you have a project, suddenly, with a business plan that is because of your reading and highlights that you have had. Next, please. And then, fortune will bring you to good people, inshallah, and those people who you have met. And you have, while meeting, you wanted to listen. You wanted to link it to your cause. You wanted to link it to your purpose. You wanted to link it to your profession. You established a relationship. Your readings. Everything that we have spoke about are fortunate for you. And you have to look at these fortunes. And then look for people who listened in return to you. Who are actually in the same line of your cause. What you would do then is be granted a virtue. You will be granted a virtue. The virtue is basically the excellence of morale. And that in your career, when you have that virtue, you will start seeing the quantum leap of excellence. But wait for the virtue. Sorry, don't wait for the virtue, wait for the fortune. So, waiting for the fortune does not mean just waiting for it. It means because you're putting a lot of effort, it will come. Just wait for it. Now, the tactics that you do in order to build that virtue, build your network, and we spoke about, you have to be innovative in building a network. Now, we have private sector leaders. If you knock on their doors as students, are they going to say no? No, they're not going to say no. They would want to actually welcome you dearly with open hearts. So you need to have a network of people in business. You need to have in the business community, in the leadership community. When you grow and when you become something, inshallah, you're already something. Still, you still need to have a network and communication and relationships with youth. Keep your relationship open with youth. Keep your relationship open with communities such as NGOs, non-profit organizations, and. Actually, let me give a few more examples. Government, have a relationship in government. And schools, have a relationship with your school, with your mosque, have a relationship with your mosque. Look for community pockets and have a network of people that you engage with in these pockets. Always, consistently, keep this relationship open. Don't ever break that bridge. Why? Well, before I talk about the beauty of failure, I'll tell you why. It's because one day, those pockets of network, pockets of relationships, will lead to spheres of learning and collaborative communities. And I'll give you the tactic in the last part of this presentation on how to do that. But before I say that, before I say that, I want to urge you to fail. Failure will be the best thing that will happen to you in your life, especially if it was at early stages. Fail and fail again. But when you do that, and when you fail, learn. Document what you have failed in. Write down what are the learning lessons learned, what are the learning experiences out of this failure, and then fail again. Failing, for instance, in business, is an MBA. If you fail, then you pick yourself up and you go and proudly say, I have failed beautifully. Be proud of it and fail again. Now, I bet my life on anything that none of the entrepreneurs who are extremely successful today did not fail in a project, did not fail in their process, did not fail in any of their milestones. And we have an entrepreneur here today, and I think he will talk about this as well, but didn't fail until they got it right. So it's really a beauty that you should not fear and not be hesitant to fail. Next, please. Okay, so we spoke about the checklist and the journey. We spoke about your DNA, what do you need to have as traits, your behavior, your attitude before you get into your career journey. And now you have reached levels in your career where you can sit back and say, I've got knowledge, I've been fortunate enough, I have developed virtues. What's next? Now you have an obligation. Your obligation, it's for your community. And trust me, if you think holistically and you reach out to your community and you make it as a cause, as a milestone in your career, you will succeed from the starting point of your career. So how do we do that? Next, please. You go and you look for your people in the networks that you have built. You have built networks with community centers, with your business community, with youth community, with creative industry community, and because they trust in you, in that first virtue, they can share their common benefits with you. And they don't know each other, by the way. You know them all because they are in different networks. Now you can trigger common benefits. But before you do that, promote your cause. You have a cause, you have a purpose, talk about it indirectly. In every gathering, in every community gatherings that you get in, talk about what's your purpose in life. And one day, in those communities, in these pockets of communities, someone will say, I have a common benefit like you. And you link that person with another person who has that common benefit. Please, next. So I spoke about this, you're surfacing the common benefit. Next, please. And what happens? I suddenly found someone in a society, charity organization, who never heard of this leader in the private sector. I'll give you an example, actually, to bring it to life. Recently, I did a workshop with Princess Albandari, who is a great, mashallah, female leader, and she is running King Khaled Foundation. The King Khaled Foundation is a foundation that gives funds and grants to charity organizations to do initiatives. Now, she wants to engage with the private sector. I have arranged for her, with her, to have a workshop with private sector leaders, and guess who came? McDonald, Al-Hukair, Al-Shaya, Al-Abekan, IKEA, Babri Jamil, and so on and so on. People that are completely in different industries, yeah? Completely different. And then NGOs, NPOs, Al-Nahda organization, Majid Society, or whatever, different NGOs with different benefits, different goals. But guess what? At the end of the workshop, and I had everybody do a 5-minute presentation because I believe in everybody's cause in that room. I selected them intentionally. They all saw something in each other. So today, we have McDonald talking to Al-Abekan. We have McDonald talking to IKEA, and Al-Hukair is really interested in Al-Abekan learning, e-learning solution, and so on. And the NGOs are also linked to those people with common benefits. A spread of a new community was created of people that never knew each other, never knew that they had common benefits. And you can be that focal point and that link. So that happened once, but you have to do it again. Different groups, so do that again. After that, you can sit back and enjoy the show. Why? Because you have created a chain effect. Now, the more you do that, the more you can sit back. But it's just how comfortable are you? So you sit back comfortably as you build more of those communities. I don't know if I delivered this correctly and clearly, but the point here and what I'm trying to deliver is it's in you. You are definitely someone who has a talent. You're definitely someone who has a skill. You're going to be something if you find your cause, and there is a process to spread that cause. And wait till you, and make it a point in your career, a goal in your career to spread it out to your community. However, after you sit and back and enjoy, next please, you will develop what we call wisdom. Wisdom will come from failure. You will fail and learn, you will fail and learn, you will document your learnings, you will spread, you will talk to others, you will build networks of communities, you will have a lot of people around you that trust in you because you have those traits. You will have wisdom at some point of your career. And what's important is to spread this wisdom. But you spread it to those who listen. And listening is not hearing, is listening. If someone listens to you and he is there as a good listener, give him the wisdom that you have. Thank you very much.